हेलो, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर चैतन्य एंड वेलकम टू द माय न्यू यूट्यूब वीडियो।
सो कमिंग टू द प्रैक्टिकल नंबर 6 ऑफ द जीआईटी। इन दिस प्रैक्टिकल यू हैव टू राइट डाउन दिस थिंग्स एंड ग्रॉस फीचर्स वी विल सी अबाउट द अल्सर्स ऑफ डिफरेंट इन्फेक्शन रीजन। सो देर आर द बेसिकली टू टाइप्स ऑफ इंटेस्टाइन, दैट इज स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन एंड लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन। सो दिस टू इंटेस्टाइन्स विल हैव द सेपरेट टाइप्स ऑफ अल्सर्स। वेन इट इज इन स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, most probably the ulcers originate from the either duodenal ulcers, typhoid ulcers, tuberculosis ulcer, whereas in case of the large intestine, bacillary, amoebic and tuberculosis hypoplastic variant is more common. Other than this, Crohn's ulcer is common in the both like small and large intestine. Pseudomembranous colitis is also there in the both, and the ischemic bowel disease is also common in the both, that is in the large intestine and small intestine. So before going to the ulcer, in previous practical only we learned that how to describe the ulcer, that is the location, curvature, number, size, shape, margin, age and the floor. If you are not able to understand this, please see the previous practical where I have commented that how to describe the ulcer. Here just I want to mention one point, that while describing the ulcer, last time I told the organ like stomach and duodenum, greater curvature like that, you should tell. But in case of the intestinal ulcer, you should say that whether ulcer is in the small intestine or the large intestine. And second thing is, either ulcer is from the mucosal surface or from the serosal surface. The another point while describing the large and small intestine is, you should talk about the intestinal lines and from the inside to the outside. For example, in case of the small or large intestine, there is from mucosal lining is by the epithelium, then lamina propria. So epithelium and lamina propria made the mucosal lining. Below that there is a submucosa, which is the most important part. Then there is a muscularis mucosa, and then there is a your serosal surface. So either you should start description from this side, that is from mucosal surface, and come to the serosal surface, or either you should start the description from the serosal side and you should go to the mucosal side. So these points are the add-on points to the previous description ulcers. Now coming to the today's practical, that is the ulcers of the small intestine. There are the two main types of the ulcers in the small intestine. One is tuberculosis origin and another one is typhoid origin. Tuberculosis, we all know that due to the tuberculosis bacteriae or bacilli. Typhoid is due to the salmonella bacilli. So these are the two different infectious origin ulcers most common in our small intestine. So tuberculosis ulcer is basically transversely placed, whereas in case of the typhoid, it is the longitudinally placed. So this is the main difference. Second difference is that as the tuberculosis ulcers are transversely placed, basically because they spread transversely, there will be the stricture and intestinal obstruction of the intestine. Whereas in case of the typhoid ulcer, they are longitudinally placed, so that there will be the perforation and peritonitis is the most common cause. Under the microscopy, we know that it is a granulomatous inflammation. So in granuloma, we have a necrosis in the center. Around that, there are the epithelioid cells or the slippery cells, which are slipper shaped, and around that there are the lymphocytes. So this is the structure of the granuloma, which can be seen in the tuberculosis under the microscopy. So considering this difference, now coming to the main specimen, this is a formalin preserved specimen of the small intestine measuring around 11 cm, and here you can see that there are the multiple ulcers which are from the variable sizes around from the 2 cm to 3 cm. So these are all ulcers which are placed transversely. So this is the specimen of tuberculosis ulcer. How will you describe? This is the formalin preserved wet mount, formalin preserved specimen of intestine measuring around 11 cm on the mucosal surface. You see the ulcers from variable sizes from 2 to 3 cm placed transversely. So here I have not able to show the other side of this specimen. On the serosal surface, you have the on the serosal surface of the same specimen, you have the nodules. So that is the another feature of tuberculosis ulcer. Coming to the
Typhoid ulcer, it is again a formalin, wet mount formalin piezo specimen of small intestine, ileum measuring around 16 cm. It is the formalin piezo specimen around 16 cm showing the two ulcers here, and these are placed longitudinally. These ulcers are placed longitudinally and measuring around 2 into 3 cm. The central area shows necrosis, the border shows the hyperemia and the thickening. Ulcer is oval in shape and the floor is showing shagginess. So these all are the features of this ulcer, which is called as the typhoid ulcer and which is placed longitudinally. So these are the description points. Again, it is on the mucosal surface. This ulcer is on the mucosal surface, and on the serosal surface from the outer side there are no nodules. So that's how you should differentiate between these two. Coming to the large intestinal ulcers, bacillary and amoebic ulcers are the in the large intestine, which are caused by the different infectious origin, like bacillary dysentery is mostly caused by the salmonella dysentery, flexionary, boidia and sonnei, whereas amoebic dysentery is a parasitic, that is entamoeba histolytica. This is due to the bacterial origin, this is due to the parasite origin. We don't have a specimen of the amoebic dysentery, but we have a specimen of the bacillary dysentery. Actually, here you can see that many linear ulcers are there, small and linear ulcers are there, and in between that ulcers, the mucosal folds are somewhere flattened and somewhere they become swollen or edematous. So whenever there is an epithelium, in between there is ulcer. So if ulcer is there, this normal epithelium is becoming edematous. So this is actually a picture of Turkish towel or old Iranian carpet. So this appearance actually meet with these two things, that is the Turkish towel or old Iranian carpet. So this is the specimen of the sigmoid colon measuring around 33 cm, formalin preserved wet mount specimen showing the many linear ulcer measuring from around 1 to 3 cm on the mucosal surface, and in between area showing the edema of various areas of edema, and the serosal surface is again unremarkable. So this is the specimen of bacillary dysentery. In amoebic dysentery, the classical feature is under the microscope. These are flush shaped ulcers, and you can see the amoeba on the margins of this flush shape. So that is the characteristic feature of the amoebic dysentery specimen. We don't have this specimen. So these are the two large intestines. Coming to the last part, that is the Crohn's ulcers and ulcerative colitis. Again, this is basically theoretical part. We don't have the specimen. These are the actually endoscopic picture of the ulcerative colitis, thanks to the Twitter pathwalker from where I took this copyrighted photographs. Here you can see that these are the superficial ulcers, which are endoscopic view of the colon showing that, and the similar microscopic feature of the same site. You can see that this is the epithelium and these are the ulcers, which are superficial basically. So this is the ulcerative colitis picture. Rest other things has been covered for the theory. So coming to the last part, that is the take home message. We learn the three specimens. This one is the showing sigmoid colon around 33 cm long and showing the Turkish towel appearance or Iranian carpet appearance as it is fed up. Now third one is, there are the many linear ulcers here, and these linear ulcers you can see clearly the mucosal fold is normal over here, whereas here it is edematous. So this is a specimen of bacillary dysentery. Okay, now next specimen, where you can see that this is the again formalin preserved specimen around 16 cm long, showing the one ulcer, 2 into 3 cm necrotic area, thickened margin, floor is shaggy. On the mucosal surface, again serosal surface is the normal or unremarkable. So this is the specimen of bacillary dysentery. This is the specimen of typhoid ulcer. So coming to the next specimen, again around 11 cm length, and many transverse ulcers on the mucosal surface varying from the 1 to 3 cm, and on the serosal surface you get nodules. So this is the specimen of tuberculosis ulcer. So this is the today's practical. Thank you very much.